Hello kid, today we are going to learn which are the times of emergency and how do we keep ourselves safe during the times of emergency. Well, over here we can see our mother Earth. Isn't she beautiful? Of course she is. Just imagine how would we keep ourselves safe in our shelter if it had not provided the soil on which the houses are built? How would we even breathe if the atmosphere was not there? And what would we drink if the water was not there? Well, Mother Nature provides us everything and it makes sure that we have everything to be comfortable. But there are some difficult times when the children of Mother Earth have to suffer. Well, these are the times when there is a fire or an earthquake or a flood or a cyclone, and when people lose their shelter and finally they have to suffer. Let's see a few incidents on this. Let's see what are the natural disasters. Well, the natural disasters are the calamities that happen naturally and are out of our control. We cannot control them and finally we lose our shelter. So let's see few examples of natural disasters. Just look at the situation. The earth is shaking and the house is just collapsing. Can you imagine how scary it is? Oh my God, the house is just gone in a fraction of a second. A similar kind of incident happened in the year 2001 in Bhuj, Gujarat. There was an earthquake which only lasted for 2 minutes, and just look at the condition what it had created. All the houses were demolished, the buildings had crashed, and people just lost their shelter in a fraction of a second. You know what? Around 12,300 people were killed and millions of structures were destroyed, which included some tourist spots and some historic buildings as well. Next, we see a cyclone. There are strong gusts of winds and they come in a huge speed. Well, can you see? They can even uproot the trees because they are coming with such a huge force. See, the tree just fell down. And if you imagine yourself in such a condition, can you imagine how scary it would be? Of course it is. Well, a similar situation happened in the Eastern Indian storm, which snatched 5 lakh homes over here. Can you see? Due to the strong gusts of winds, trees were uprooted and the shelters were completely destroyed. And so many people were just going around to find a new shelter. Now see how the roads have been converted into rivers. The water is flowing and these cars are just being moved away as if they're just toy cars. Well, this is a flood condition wherein there is a lot of water coming in and they are just simply taking away whatever it can. Whether it's the vehicles, the houses, everything is just going away with the flow of water. Well, in 2013, we saw a similar condition in the Indian state of Uttarakhand and some adjoining states, wherein the rainfall was 375% more than the normal rainfall. It happened due to a cloudburst and there was this flood scenario. But what is a cloudburst? Well, a cloudburst is a situation in which there is a huge amount of precipitation in a short duration of time. This can eventually create a flood condition, and the similar thing we saw in Uttarakhand. Well, over here also the cloudburst had happened and the Chorabari glacier had melted, which resulted in huge amount of water and the water level increased and houses were drowned. Many people lose their lives in these kind of situations. Now we see a cyclone condition in a place nearby the sea. Can you see the water is coming with such huge force and the waves are becoming more and more? Well, this is a cyclonic condition. A similar kind of situation had happened in the year 2013 when Cyclone Phailin just came and hit the state of Orissa. Can you see how the water has come in? And it has drowned the cars, it has got inside the buildings. Even we can see the roofs of the Kachcha houses had come down. Not only that, the trees were uprooted and so many people, just see over here, they had become shelterless. They are trying to just comfort themselves in whatever they are getting. So this is the condition when a cyclone hits a particular area. But why does a cyclone takes place? Well, a cyclone is a storm wherein there are spiral thunderstorms in a particular area of low atmospheric pressure. So when an atmospheric pressure in a particular place dips, then the wind from the adjoining areas come and try to fill in the place. This way, they create the spiral thunderstorms because of the rotation of the earth. So instead of directly going there, it creates a spiral movement. So this creates the cyclone. Now we come across a forest fire. Well, can you see over here, such a large amount of forest has caught fire and the shelter inside the forest will get totally destroyed due to this fire. What if your house was in that place? Wouldn't you think it's very, very scary? Of course it is. But how does it happen? Let's see. The fire is just expanding from one place to another. How it's just increasing by touching each tree and it is completely destroying whatever is coming in its way. But how does it start? Let's see that. So when lightning strikes, it comes and falls on the leaves. So what happens is, they catch fire, and in this way, from one tree to another tree, the fire spreads very, very rapidly in a forest. So this is how the forest fire takes place. The same kind of situation happened in the year 2016, where a forest fire had broken out in the forests of Uttarakhand. So a large volume of the forest had got burnt. Not only did it shatter all the shelter, but also a great amount of resource like the wood, that is timber, which is used to make different kinds of furniture. So in these ways, forest fires are very, very destructive. So now, here we have a question. What happened to the houses due to these disasters? Is it option A, they got transferred to a safe place, or option B, they got destroyed? Or else, is it option C, they vanished and then reappeared? What do you think would be the correct answer? Well, we saw in all of these natural disasters that the houses did not get transferred to a safe place. So this is a wrong option. Neither did they vanished and reappeared again. So what will be the correct answer? They got destroyed. Well, over here we see a lady sitting over here because she has lost her shelter due to a natural disaster. But what do you think happens to her after this? Do you think she just continues sitting there and crying? Would it help her out? Not really. So how does she get help? Let's see. Well, in case of natural disasters, you get help from the people living in the same area as well as people from the distant area. See? First of all, the people living nearby are helping you in the rescuing option. And even the people from far away has sent the disaster relief. Over here, we can see the Indian Army carrying out the relief operations. See how they are rescuing the people who are suffering because of natural calamities or the natural disasters. Not only rescuing, they are also providing them with the relief funds, that is the food, package and medical things. Other than the Indian Army, we have got some voluntary organizations and the non-government organization, that is the NGOs. Like over here, we see the Red Cross Society distributing relief materials like packaged food, drinking water and woolen blankets to the victims. Not only this, well, they also provide medical camps so that they can prevent the diseases from getting widespread over here. Over here, we can see they are putting up the tents for the people who have lost their shelter in the natural disaster. So, in this way, the Indian Army and other rescue team put up this shelter so that they can help out the victims over here. Even here, we see the disaster relief camps. See how people are getting shelter over here, at least till the time their houses are rebuilt by the government agencies. So, in this way, the victims are supported after the natural disasters have happened. But even in these kind of situations, you need to be safe. So, we have got some kits which will help you to be safe in these kind of situations. But before that, let's have a question. Who carries out disaster relief operations? Is it option 1, the hospitality services, option 2, the emergency services, or option 3, the food and lodging services? Well, over here we had seen that the Indian Army and the different NGOs coming and helping them out. So the correct answer will be the emergency services and not the hospitality services or the food and lodging services. So now let's see what are the kits. The first kit is the disaster survival kit. What is it called? Well, it is the first aid kit because this is used for immediate help in these kind of emergency situation, that is the times of emergency. So what are the things that you need to put in the kit? Let's see. First, you need to have the medicines, then the hand sanitizer, scissors, safety pins, cotton balls. Following that, we have got the thermometer, tube of petroleum jelly, sunscreen, antiseptic ointment and the antiseptic wipes. Now, why are these things required? Because in case of any injury, these things will help you to get the immediate help. So, you need to have a first aid kit obviously ready for these kind of situations. So, next we have got the tools kit. Well, over here, first we have got a portable radio. Now, why do you think we need a radio in times of emergency? Well, this will help you to gather information or any important news update regarding the situation. Next, we have got the flashlight and extra batteries. Now, in these kind of natural disasters, it's very evident that electricity will not be there. So, how would you look out for things? For that, you need the flashlight with extra batteries. Next, we have got the matches in a waterproof container. Now, matches will help you to light the fire so that you can cook some food for yourself as well as to get some light. Next, we have got the duct tape and scissors, which will help you in cutting things. Then, we have got the plastic sheeting. If there is rainfall or water all around, this will help you to keep you dry. Next, the whistle, which will help you in calling people in times of emergency. The paper, pen and pencil to write anything important. And finally, the needles and thread, which will help you in sewing different important garments. Finally, we have got the kitchen items. Now, these things are required for preparation of food if you are in any shelter home. Well, first, we have got the household liquid to treat drinking water because in these kind of situations, many waterborne diseases can take place which can make you fall sick. So, in order to have the pure drinking water, you need to treat it. That's why you need the household liquid. Then, we have got the paper cups, plates and plastic utensils which will help you in taking the food. Then, the all-purpose knife for cutting things, manual can opener so that you can have the canned food as well. Then You have got a small cooking stove in which at least you can eat a basic meal, the aluminium foil and plastic wrap to keep your food properly, the garbage bags so that you can dump your garbage in a proper place instead of just throwing it anywhere, and finally the sugar, salt and pepper which will make your basic meal at least eatable. So now you have got to know what are the times of emergency and how you can keep yourself safe by having these kits handy. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. You can also register for free at deltastep.com to get all the learning resources as per ICC, CBSC, IB, Cambridge or any other curriculum. More than 5,000 plus amazing lectures across maths, science, English and social studies. Our unique interactive video technology keeps you engaged and our iDictionary feature allows you to quickly revise any concept. Master each topic at your own pace with our adaptive practice technology and 1 million plus questions. Get instant answers and detailed solutions. Be exam ready by taking unlimited mock tests. Performance analysis along with actionable feedback. Personal tutors to resolve your slightest of doubt. That's not all. You can also win amazing prizes like PlayStations, iPads, watches and many more along with certificates through our Earn As You Learn program. So, at deltastep.com, learning is not only fun and easy, but also rewarding. So register for free now.